When they meet, people influence each other even without speaking. They can infect each other with a contagious disease, be it something dangerous like COVID-19, or benign like the common cold, or pass on to each other new ideas based on their wearables or behavior. Hi, I'm Dr. Ernesto Damiani, Senior Director of Robotics and Intelligent System Institute, Director of the Center for Cyber-Physical Systems, and Professor of Electrical and Computer Science at Khalifa University. And together with my colleagues, Corrado Mio and Gabriele Giannini, I am a member of the team behind PLACES. PLACES is a big data system for quantifying and forecasting disease propagation speed and rate, based on people's estimated mobility. The key idea is generating an approximation of the entire population movements and whereabouts, but without compromising their privacy. People leave traces of their motion to their phones and wearable devices. Throughout the day, our phones connect to different types of networks to request services or simply to notify the network that we are in a given cell or area. These periodic connections generate network activity records, which are used by network providers to estimate cell occupancy and manage their services to the users. To understand what PLACES does, it is important to recognize the difference between network activity records and the usual GPS location data we use with conventional map applications like Google Maps. Network activity records concern all active phones. They are collected by mobile network providers and stored on their clouds. GPS data instead is obtained by triangulating signals received from satellites. It is computed by the individual phones and stored locally on each phone. Phone owners must authorize sharing of their GPS data with all apps and external services. Network activity records are difficult to process. Compared to GPS, network activity data is huge and noisy. When we are in motion, our phones generate network activity records at a higher rate than when we are staying in the same place. Each network activity record includes a location, but its precision varies a lot depending on cell size and on the technology of the mobile network, from 2G, 3G and Wi-Fi to 4G, 5G. To facilitate the processing of network activity records, the International Telecommunication Union has standardized the definition of location grids. On these grids, operators can narrow down the location of a terminal to square pixels, whose size can go from 60 by 60 meters to hundreds of meters. Taking into account the publicly available description from Google and other sources, these pixels can be enriched with metadata expressing the type of area and its intended use. Network activity records are also very sensitive. People authorize their mobile network providers to collect their activity records for statistics and billing purposes, but do not necessarily authorize their disclosure. Only the government can access them in special cases, for example, in the framework of criminal investigations. Still, petabytes of network activity data are collected worldwide every day and are used to compute collective indicators for the analysis of human mobility. For instance, the origin-destination matrix is a standard estimator of the flow between two regions. It helps to assess the economic dependence between such regions. Given n different spatial regions, the origin-destination matrix is an n by n matrix, where each cell ij represents the number of persons who moved from region I to region j. The coarse granularity of network activity data requires this matrix to be computed on a daily basis as the minimum reliable aggregation. For privacy, PLACES imports network activity records in an unlinked form, which means that each network activity record is countersigned via an opaque identifier that is different every time. In other words, the same phone connecting to two cells in two different moments will generate two distinct identifiers. This is different from using an anonymous but persistent identifier that stays the same for all the activities of a given phone. Indeed, persistent identifiers should be avoided because they can easily be de-anonymized. For instance, one can compute the most frequent position of an anonymous identifier to find the home location and then use knowledge of the apartment rent contracts to re-identify the corresponding person. PLACES uses network activity data only to calibrate its understanding of how people move around in a country or a region, to compute pixel-level versions of origin-destination matrices. Based on this information, Places calibrates internal mobility models, which capture how many pixels each person will be visiting in the course of a time period, and for how long each person will remain in each pixel. Once the models are calibrated, the Places simulator's engine generates hundreds of thousands of simulated users, places them on the pixel grid, and assigns each to a calibrated mobility model. Also, each simulated user is assigned an initial condition, for example, infected, non-infected. Places mobility models are iteratively run for multiple epochs, each corresponding to an elapsed time period, for example, a week. Places models can predict the occupancy of each pixel at different times and estimate the propagation of the condition according to the encounter probabilities. In the course of a simulation, the Places engine handles hundreds of millions and even billions of locations. At the end, the total amount of infected people can be estimated, together with other parameters of interest for urban planning and decision-making, like the contribution of each pixel to the spreading. An important point is modeling the cross-border intake of cases when initializing and updating the location of Places simulated user. Identifying inlets and estimating their contribution can provide additional insight and add to the commercial value of the results. In this view, Places has been adapted to work with the Oceana system, developed by the Canadian company GSTS. Oceana is a maritime intelligence system that processes satellite data together with other data sets harvested from the ocean, weather, and port activity sources to provide decision-making information. It supports maritime security as well as optimization of port operations and logistics. An important application of Oceana is risk management, including detection of illegal or irregular activities at ports, as well as of regulatory and environmental non-compliance. Oceana is already adopted worldwide. It provides the capability to estimate the risk of contagion associated to passengers and crew disembarking from all types of ships, based on their source port, their journey, and the ship's characteristics. Researchers from both sides have collaborated towards using Oceana risk estimates to continuously update Places simulations. This allows us to estimate the impact of incoming flows of infection. Also, Places estimates regarding source ports can be used to initialize Oceana's maritime risk estimations. Hopefully, this project paves the way to collaborative estimation and shared management of all risk of disease propagation linked to cross-border mobility of people and goods. Thank you very much.